If you look today to hire anybody, you will find thousands of people with MBAs. They all want to work for you and so forth and so on. The question is actually how much can they produce for you? I don't know. If, on the other hand, I look for a good electrician or a reliable carpenter or plumber, it's very difficult to find. So I think that the generation that grew up, say, during the Depression and in the 1950s, they were, in the 50s, a worker in America had a very high social standing. He was earning a lot of money. He could travel to Europe, and with the then prevailing exchange rate, he could really spend a lot of money in Europe. But the view then, whether that came from the government or the media or simply from the workers themselves, was a workman's job is a lower class job. We want our children to be academics. And a lot of people are not suited to be in academics, or they don't know really how to apply their knowledge that they have acquired at universities, if anything is acquired. That is a big question. And so you have now an army of people that came out of universities, and I can tell you, I mean, a lot of these people I would not dream of hiring. Not dream. They're completely useless. Now, I'm not saying that everybody is useless. Some have very good education and very good personality. But the ones that I would hire them with or without university degree. I would look at them. Can they do something? Are they effective? Can they accomplish something or not? I wouldn't even ask whether they have a university education. I'm not interested in that. In general, if you want to be a medical doctor, I can understand that you need to go to medical school. If you want to be an engineer or architect, then I can understand you need to go to a technical college. If you want to be, a teacher, then maybe it's useful to know something and go to a university and so forth. But for most people, I don't think that education is that important. It's probably important in the sense that at least when I studied, you were given a job to do, a paper to do, maybe a subject about which you had no clue. They had to go and study and learn about this subject. So by studying at the university, you learned how to learn something about which you didn't have a clue. And you also finally learned how to talk about things about which you have no clue, which is very important in business. A deflationary bust, whenever it may happen, it may only happen in 10 years' time, but it would seem to me that this is the eventual outcome. It could also happen tomorrow. It could happen in 10 years' time. It's the opposite from an increase in asset prices from inflation. Now, if you look at how asset prices have increased since 1980, it's been highly irregular. Stocks rose strongly until 87, then they had a setback, and after 87, some markets made new highs, but others didn't. And then you had some regions like America doing particularly well between 1988 and 1994. And so growth shifts around and asset prices rise, but at with different intensity. And we had a collapse in the Nasdaq, but other stocks continued to go up until 2007, whereas the Nasdaq was still 50% below its high and is still, even today, 40% below its high in 2000. And so I think in a collapse, what happens is that over time, everything goes down, but some things go down more than others. And traditionally, I would say the best in a collapse is to hold cash. But then the question arises, what kind of a cash you should hold and in what form? Because if you have bank deposits, and I think what happened in Cyprus is a blueprint. Maybe you have bank deposits, maybe not all of it will be paid to you. And in some sovereign countries, maybe it will be paid to you and in others not, depending on the quality of the banking system. But in general, I think if there was a collapse, all banks would suffer. And then I would imagine that cash would not be necessarily the safest investment. And then the currency choice is also, would you put all your money into US dollars? Because, yeah, the US dollar may be strong for another 3 months, maybe another 3 years, but maybe eventually it will be a very weak currency, as I would expect. Then you may turn around and say, well, weak, but weak against what? Maybe not against the euro. Because if the others also print money, the dollar paper money may be weak, but because they all print, they may paper monies will all go down in purchasing power in kind of concert. And so maybe gold is a part of the solution to have some money in gold, and maybe you need to own some real estate. Then you turn around and say, yeah, real estate, but where? You know, then I say, okay, if you had, say, you lived in Germany in 1900, and we are now 2013, if you had all your money in cash, in Germany, 1900, you lost it 3 times. In World War I, then hyperinflation, and World War II. So cash was not a desirable alternative, nor government bonds, also lost 3 times. If you own shares of the leading German companies, most of them are still in business, may not have been the best investment, but you still have these shares, so you preserved your wealth. If you had real estate, then the question arises, if your grandparents had the bad luck to own the real estate in Eastern Europe and East Germany, you lost it all after World War II. But if you had the fortune to have it in West Germany, then you are okay. So do people say, well, real estate is safe? Yes, to some extent, but you also need to diversify. It's like a stock portfolio. You shouldn't put necessarily all your money in one stock, but you should have a diversified portfolio, because companies also die, they go out of business eventually. When I started to work in 1970, two of the most respected and companies that were considered buy and put it in a drawer and never look at it again were Polaroid and Kodak, and both are out of business. So there is the question of obsolescence, and the same happens to real estate. For political reasons, you may lose it. So I would say, we don't know how the world will look like in 5 or 10 years' time. Nobody has a clue. There are some people will say, it will look this way, it will look that way. I'm very skeptical of any forecast, especially long-term forecasts.